Hey y'all, what's up? It's me again, back with another voiceover. And I promise you, I'm not gonna drive y'all crazy with these voiceovers, although I do like them. But whenever I am cooking or something like that, I like to jam my little music. And sometimes I put off vlogging because I'm like, oh, I don't want to get copywritten. But yeah, I'm drumming some Maze, Silky Soul. That's the music choice for today's dinner. But anyway, I don't want to get copywritten, so I choose not to vlog. But I was like, nope, I'm not going to do that anymore. If I'm jamming my music, I am going to just do a voiceover, y'all. So tonight we are having fried catfish, cheesy potatoes, and some stuffed jalapenos, and y'all are invited for dinner, okay? So first I turn my music on, put me some jams on. Y'all know if y'all see that speaker over there lit up, that means I'm jamming, okay? So anyway, right here we have some jalapenos. They're already chopped up. This is going to be for the inside of the jalapenos, the cream cheese and the ranch. It's the same way that I make this dip. I don't know if I ever recorded that, but it's this cream cheese ranch powder dip. Oh my god, it's so good. I'll show y'all another time. There's that white cheddar cheese. I told y'all to put it in anything that requires cheese. And since I'm making those potatoes, I'm adding that in there. I'm gonna put that in there with some heavy whipping cream, some of this good old cheese right here. It's like the HEB brand Velveeta, but hey, it does the job and it's way cheaper, okay? excuse me, y'all. So anyway, I'm about to chop up these potatoes and then get those in the oven. I should have boiled them first because it did end up taking a long time to cook. But I had to like bake them like over and over with the cheese. So I was like, maybe 2 hours, okay? But it still turned out good. Yeah, I know I'm chopping a whole lot of the potato off. My Uncle Kevin, hey, Uncle Kevin. We were on live one day, like on video chat with my mom, and I was chopping potatoes, and he was like, dang, you're cutting a lot of those the potato off with the skins. You should make something with it, you know? So I should have kept those and made, I think he suggested like some potato chip type things. I did keep the last ones for a while, but I never made them and threw them away. But anyway, y'all, so I'm chopping up these potatoes. I end up going to this CATFISH and got some good old fresh catfish and stuff. So I got that over there sitting, waiting while the fryer is getting hot. Hold on. Yeah, I was going to keep y'all posted on what's jamming. This is my favorite song, y'all. Reasons by Frankie Beverly and Maze. I said if I ever get married, I am walking down the aisle to this song. I mean, I had to jam this, y'all. I had to take a little break because that is my song. I mean, just go listen to it. If you never heard of it, just listen to it. Listen to the words. It's like so beautiful. But anyway, back to cooking. So anyway, there's the fish. I'm about to put it inside of the dip. I use the Louisiana mix or whatever. It's easy, it's already seasoned, and that's it. So it makes it so simple. So I'm just gonna coat it up and then I'm gonna put it inside of the fryer. Y'all, I love that fryer. That fryer was only, I think, maybe like $40 or something at Walmart, and it is the bomb, okay? I don't fry a lot, but lately I have been, but it is the bomb. You put it in this little basket, you just drop it down, and then you just sit there and you just wait. I mean, it's the bomb. I don't like to fry because, one, I don't like to get popped. But this thing here does not pop. It does not let the grease come out. So anyway, let's look at those pretty golden catfish. Oh, my gosh. So then you just sit it on the little corner thing. You see the little hook right there. And you just let it, let the grease kind of drip out from it or whatever. But, yeah, and then I just got my pan ready. And I will just, that's the first batch coming out, y'all. It was so good. So that's catfish and catfish nuggets. And then I got the chopped up potatoes right there sitting in some water. Y'all, I love cooking for my family. Like, I mean, I cook a lot. Sometimes it does get tiresome. And sometimes you have those days where you be like, I just don't feel like cooking. You know, so we eat out. But I just like cooking for my family. I've always been like that, even when it was just me and the girls. I mean, I know they say that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. But honestly, when you think about it, the way to your family's heart and to let them know, like a way that you can let them know how much you love them, is by cooking them a good meal. Like, seriously, it makes me so happy when I cook the girls up a good meal, and especially when they say it's good. Now, that makes me even happier, okay? But just to see them eat and get full and the food is good and it's not like some outside fast food all the time, it makes me feel good. And not just my girls, I mean, my family too. I'm telling you, if somebody makes me a good meal, one of my family members, hey girl, come on over, let me cook. This is the dip, y'all, that's gonna go inside the cream, inside the jalapenos. I'm just talking right now. Now I'm jamming some Isley Brothers. But if somebody invites me over for a good meal, I promise you, I mean, even if it's not good, it's just the point that they put their, they cooked it and cooked it for me. And I'm sure they cooked it with love if they took their time and they invited me over. I mean, I'd be like, you know, they gotta love me. They done fed me this good old meal. They gotta love me. So, yeah, y'all, I just think that cooking is just a way that you can show your family members how much you love them. It's just another way. So I love cooking for my family, y'all. So anyway, now I am going to do, oh, let me tell y'all what I'm going to do right here is the potatoes. Now, this is a different way. I'm doing it different. I put the bouillon in there for more flavor. A little different, okay? I'm always switching up something. But I'm going to grill up these grill up these onions. I got some olive oil in there. Grill up these onions, and then I'm going to add them to the potatoes. But first, I'm going to grill them up before I pour all this other stuff in there. All right, y'all, you know I'm jamming Pandora. Oh, my God, this is another one of my jams. I love me some Marvin Gaye. Marvin Gaye was a cool dude, y'all. He went through a lot of stuff, too. I got interested in his life, like, a few years ago and got to looking him up because I'm like, I love his music so much. I want to know, like, more about him. But anyway, cool dude, great music. Here's some of the seasonings I'm going to use. Y'all, I just started using Old Bay, okay? Yes, I'm a new Old Bay user, and it's good. I like that it has a little kick to it. And yeah, I just started using it maybe a few months ago. Of course, I got my parsley so I can make things look real pretty. Y'all know parsley don't taste like nothing. Here's the jalapenos. Excuse me. Now, you can do them with, right now I'm seasoning up the potatoes. The jalapenos, though, you can wrap them with bacon if you want. That's what I was trying to say. I've done that as well, but this time we're not going to do that. So right now I'm seasoning up the potatoes because what I'm going to do is season them up and then put them in the oven for a little bit, short amount of time. I don't even remember how much I put them in. Yeah, I made a big boo-boo right there, y'all. I accidentally had the garlic powder open on the wrong side, so it just kind of poured out. But you know, hey, it's not salty, so it's all good. I'm going to put some, I'm going to season the potatoes, and then I'm going to put them in the oven for a little bit, and just like so that seasoning can stick to the potatoes. Yeah, so that seasoning can stick to the potatoes. So yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. And so y'all will see that. There's my Old Bay, y'all. I know people use it on seafood, but I just use it on everything. So that's the ending product. Should have added some more parsley on there, you know, because I like my stuff to look real pretty. But you know, it is what it is. So I'm putting it in the oven. And okay, so I put it on 400. I can't remember how long. I just knew it wasn't going to be that long. 12 minutes. Okay, so now we're back to the grilled onions. The onions are grilled. The bouillon is then dissolved. So now I'm put some heavy whipping cream in there. And then I'm going to add everything else. So yeah, now these cheesy potatoes, I have made them before, but last time I made them with red potatoes, okay? And it was just easier that way. Red potatoes don't take long. They don't take that long. I decided to add some cream and mushroom in there as well to make it real creamy. But these took longer. These took much longer. Yeah, they did. Next time I'll use red potatoes. But anyway, let's move on over to the jalapenos. Y'all, these jalapenos are actually not hot, okay? Like, my boyfriend took a bite, and he loved them, and he does not eat spicy food, okay? Like, when I say don't eat spicy food, he don't eat spicy food. But it's like, after you cook them, they lose the spice. I don't know. They still have flavor, but they lose the spice. Well, anyway, that little mixture that I made with the cream cheese, usually I put bacon bits in them, but I didn't because he doesn't eat pork, so I'm just going to top a few of them off with bacon bits. So anyway, I just put the little dip in there. So now I'm going to bake them. So this is how they look before they go into the oven. And before I add the cheese and the bacon bits and stuff like that. Yeah, it's going to be so good. So real quick, let's check on the cheese rule. You don't want to burn the cheese. It burns so quick. So I had to turn around, take a little break from the jalapenos because I was going to, like, you know, zoom in, show y'all the cooked, and bam, next clip. I mean, to show y'all the uncooked, and bam, next clip is the cooked. So, yeah, anyway, you had to stir that up real quick. Now, I took the potatoes out the oven, I'm adding a little cheese first, and I'm going to mix it up just so it could be extra cheesy. Y'all know we love cheese around here, okay? So I already got cheese in the pot. I'm going to put cheese on the inside, mix it up, and I'm going to put more cheese on the top, okay? Yes, we love cheese. And I just, yeah, I'm addicted. So that's what I'm doing right now. I just added a little cheese in there. What else? Oh, I still need to add a little seasoning into the actual roux. I mean, I know the cheese sauce can be a little salty, but not quite. You know, I put a little adobo in there, adobo or whatever it's called. I like that seasoning. It's not real salty to me. So yeah, there's the cheese sauce. It's all done nice and creamy, nice creamy and cheesy. So I'm pouring those into the potatoes. And then I'm going to mix them up. So, bam, there you go. Mixed up real good. Topped it off with a little parsley, of course, to make it pretty. And then from there, I am going to put it in the oven. I'm going to cover it with foil and put it in the oven. Y'all, let me tell y'all. The cabbage. Sorry, cabbage. Cabbage didn't make it to dinner. Yeah, by the time I did all that frying, all that, it didn't make it. I know we're eating bad tonight, and we probably needed those vegetables. I know we did, but we do eat a lot of vegetables, y'all. And, you know, I'm sorry, just not tonight. So, yeah, the poor little cabbage. I'm sorry, cabbage, but you have been uninvited to dinner. You're not going to make it tonight. All right, y'all, here we go. It's all done. Y'all, these things were the bomb, okay? Like I said, the jalapenos are not hot anymore. They, after I baked them, they weren't hot. They weren't spicy anymore, so they were really good. And I did leave some without bacon on there for miracle. And my boyfriend, and there's the fish. It was so tasty, y'all. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next vlog. Thank y'all for coming to dinner with us tonight. Alrighty, arrivederci.